The Model Y, as well as other upcoming Tesla electric vehicles or new versions of existing models, are always hot topics. Tesla is planning a new entry-level Model Y for the 2023 model year with standard range all-wheel drive. It will be powered by 4680 type cylindrical battery cells and manufactured in Texas. This speculation is based on the Environmental Protection Agency's recent approval of three 2023 Model Y variants. Welcome to First Class Tech. In this video, we'll take a look at Tesla's preparation to launch 4680 Standard Range AWD Model Y for 2023. Tesla is planning to launch a new Model Y trim in 2023 with a Standard Range all-wheel drive configuration and 4680 batteries that have just received EPA approval. Tesla applied for and received Certificates of Conformity for various Model 3, Model X and Model S trim levels in October, but the Model Y was never listed in the EPA's database. It was surprising but not alarming because Tesla still have several months to apply for and receive approval to sell other vehicles in the 2023 model year. The EPA now has added Tesla's Model Y Certificates of Conformity for 2023 models to its database. And rather than just receiving approval for two configurations it currently sells, Tesla received three certificates of conformity for the Model Y: the Model Y Long Range All-Wheel Drive, the Model Y Performance All-Wheel Drive, and now a new trim called Model Y All-Wheel Drive have all been approved by the EPA. In April, Tesla built a Model Y with a Standard Range All-Wheel Drive powertrain at the Gigafactory, Texas, but only offered it to employees. The vehicle had a longer range of 279 miles and a more favorable AWD setup. However, it was being sold for close to $60,000, which was an exorbitant price for the range it provided. For some time, it was speculated that this was the Model Y Tesla had built with a highly anticipated 4680 cell. Because it was only available to employees, this only fueled speculation that the vehicle used the automaker's new cell chemistry. The 4680 Model Y is difficult to find. Tesla's senior vice president of powertrain, Drew Baglino, drives one, and the company is producing 4680 equipped Model Ys at the Gigafactory in Texas. However, because the 4680 program is still in its early stages, the company primarily delivers 2170 equipped Model Ys to customers. According to EPA documents, Tesla applied for the approval of the three Model Y configurations on September 30 and received certificates of conformity on October 19. The agency has not yet released specific range ratings for this trim. This could indicate that Tesla is planning to deliver an additional 4680 Model Ys to customers this year. The EPA had to inspect the vehicle before it could be delivered to customers because it uses a new chemistry with different range ratings and power outputs. The all-electric crossover may have received approval slightly later than Tesla's other three vehicles. By the end of the year, Tesla's 4680 cells could be in mass production. The company has already been developing prototypes of the cell with suppliers such as Panasonic in preparation for large-scale production in 2023. Panasonic Energy Corporation Limited President and CEO Kazuo Tadanobu stated that Tesla's 4680 cells will enter mass production on Japanese lines in May 2023. Panasonic anticipates that mass production of the 4680 cell will begin in March 2023 when the company's fiscal year begins. The cell will be manufactured initially at Panasonic's Wakayama plant. The focus will then shift to North America. Tadanobu has not previously committed to producing the 4680 cells in the United States, but now that he has stated that the company will transition production to North America, it may bring another plant to the United States. According to sources who first reported on Panasonic shipping 4680 samples to Tesla, the company is looking at sites in Kansas and Oklahoma, according to people familiar with the matter. Panasonic's only client for the new cells is Tesla. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Now, getting back to the topic, some attendees at the Cyber Rodeo were surprised to see that some of the Model Ys in the Giga Texas complex were listed as Standard Range AWD. This was quite surprising given that Tesla had not announced the vehicle and it was not available on the company's current Model Y order page. Having said that, the Cyber Rodeo attendees noticed that the vehicle appeared to have a range of 279 miles. Surprisingly, these observations corresponded to a Model Y variant that was added to the EPA website earlier this year. There were a few details available about the mysterious Model Y, though the variant was listed with a range of 279 miles. This fueled speculation that Tesla was planning to introduce a new standard range version of its best-selling all-electric crossover. These appear to have been confirmed recently, as an email reportedly sent by the company last Friday indicated that the Model Y standard range dual motor AWD is now available for purchase, albeit only for employees. The Ride the Lightning podcast host and the EV fan blog both stated that the Model Y standard range AWD would cost $59,990. The Tesla Model Y costs $59,990 and has a range of 279 miles per charge, a top speed of 135 miles per hour, and a 0 to 60 mile per hour time of 5 seconds. In comparison, Tesla currently lists the Model Y long range AWD at $62,990, which is only $3,000 more than the standard range AWD variant. The Model Y long range has an EPA estimated range of 330 miles per charge and 0 to 60 mile per hour time of 4.8 seconds. While a base variant Model Y for nearly $60,000 is undeniably expensive, the vehicle is likely to be quite popular. Unlike the Chinese-made Model Y, which is only available in rear-wheel drive, the Texas-made Model Y standard range has two electric motors. The car also has Tesla's 4680 battery cells, which are at the cutting edge of the company's technology. These advancements, to some extent, may help justify the Model Y standard range AWD's price. Tesla may begin high-volume production of its 4680 batteries by the end of this year, according to Musk, who spoke at the Tesla Cyber Roundup at Giga Texas. Musk believes Tesla will be in high-volume production by the end of 2022. He also stated that Tesla has enough battery cells to produce 1.5 million cars this year. "We're producing a good number every week, and I believe we'll be in high-volume production by the end of the year. It's always difficult to predict because there's so much new technology. What's the slope of the S-curve on the ramp, and except for that, I'm confident it will reach a high production rate. However, we won't be able to confidently reach a high production rate until the end of this year. However, this has no effect on our vehicle output. We have enough battery cell supply from suppliers to build 1.5 million cars this year. So it isn't a constraint on output, but it will be significant next year." Tesla's Cato Road plant has increased its 4680 battery output by 35% month over month. Drew Baglino, Tesla's Senior Vice President of Powertrain and Energy Engineering, spoke about the company's growth during the company's Q2 2022 earnings calls last month. "Since March of this year, the output has been increasing due to Tesla's team fully automating the power conveyance for the dry anode electrode tool. There, according to Baglino, this resulted in significant increases in production and yield improvements." He also stated that Tesla expects Giga Texas to outperform the Cato Road pilot line's weekly output by the end of this year. "We're not sure if this is a sign of a new standard range Model Y or simply a new 2023 model year of the existing 4680 powered Tesla Model Y from Texas, which is very similar to the 2170 powered model long range AWD from California. In other words, we believe it is too early to predict the release of a new entry-level model. Tesla may prefer to keep the existing two California-made models, and at some point in 2023, the automaker may officially add the Model Y AWD from Texas to the design studio. It's worth noting that the company is also producing the long-range AWD version in Texas, most likely due to a scarcity of 4680-type batteries. The Tesla Model Y AWD's wider availability is likely to be the only thing to look forward to in the near future." And with that being said, it's time to end our video. What are your views about the 4680 standard range Tesla AWD Model Y? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Like this video and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you on our next video.